Rome was not built in a day, but when founded in 753 BC, this city of eternal life, across its seven hills along the banks of the Tiber, founded by the mythical twins Romulus and Remus, suckling on the she-wolf of Rome. It began a journey of creation of one of the greatest empires the world has seen, and left within the Aurelian walls the highest concentration of historical and architectural riches in the world. Roma is a city I love, somewhere I even imagine I would call home. My uncle lived in Rome during the 70s and had many great Roman loves. The art and history, the food, the lifestyle, and not the least, the women. Young adult, the saying, when in Rome, do as the Romans do, was something I did not truly appreciate the first times I visited the city. It was only when a friend who lived in Rome showed me the city as a local that this made sense and I fell in love with the city. The city of eternal life is to be lived as a Roman and not as a tourist. A tourist might see a loud, dirty, crowded city, but as a local you see a magical lover that constantly surprises.
Roads lead to Rome. Here we are in this beautiful city in Italy, the historic site of the Roman Empire. And we're going to discover the city very quickly in the next days. We're going to quick zap, zap, zap. But anything you want to know in more detail, you got it in the zone. Arco Constantino. It's the Arc de Triomphe, or the Arc of Victory, where the Roman forces used to come back and come through the arch to celebrate their victorious campaigns around the world, around the region known as it. All roads lead to Rome, come back through this victorious arch. And of course, the mob's favorite place, the ancient Colosseum. Colosseo di Roma.
He enters Rome like a conquering hero.
The Colosseum that's inspired us to movie classic.
To give you Alias Maximus!
Such as the Gladiator, Spartacus, or those about to die. It's incredibly spectacular being paid tribute to the most spectacular shows. They are actually able to flood the arena with incredible displays to do the naval battles and reenact all the great elements of the Roman Empire. Okay.
Let the games begin!
The iconic and spectacular Colosseum of Rome is still the largest amphitheater ever built. I remember in my days jumping over the walls with my friends and playing drinking games in the middle of the Colosseum, back in the days when everything wasn't fenced off. And of course, you have the Foro Romanum, also known as the Roman Forum or the Marketplace. For centuries, the Forum is the center of day-to-day life in Rome.
Friends, Roman countrymen, lend me your ears!
Since the 8th century before Christ, the Foro Romano has been the heart and soul of the Roman Empire, the site of triumphal processions and elections, the venue of public speakers, criminal trials and gladiatorial matches, the nucleus of commercial affairs. Throughout
statues and monuments commemorating the city's leaders. It's been called the most celebrated meeting place in the world and in all history. And still today, it sees 4.5 million visitors.
The magic of Bella Roma is sotto l'alberi, under the trees. The temperature drops. We've got 36 degrees at the moment in the city of eternal life. And the life is departing from us in this heat. But when you're under the trees, there's a soft breeze and it's magical. Villa Borghese, sulla Tevere, sotto l'alberi is beautiful. Making our way up to the Buco, the Serratura, the Ordine di Malta, is the Aventine Keyhole. Amazing view, quite a walk. I'm hoping it's not going to be that busy, but potentially it could be. This is the Ordine.
This used to be one of the hidden gems of Rome. Then somebody made it public, and the tourism is ridiculous. Everyone tries to take a photo, but it's almost impossible. And as the tour guide says,
if you're looking for a picture, you find it on Google, and they all look the same. So there is no need of taking a picture, okay?
Throughout Rome, you find spectacular paths to escape the summer's heat, to wander, to lay in the sun. In the Giardini di Aranci, the Garden of Oranges is just one of those beautiful places with spectacular views and orange trees.
Stai solo blaterando contro il mio cuore sprovveduto. Lei scivola facilmente nell'abbandono totale.
So here we are at Circo Massimo, not much left of the old chariot racing location, scene of Ben Hur for the films, and beyond that is the Foro Romano, the old Roman Forum, the Citadel, and the incredible ancient city of Rome. All roads lead to Rome. Roads, Rome. Let's get tongue twisted with it. You're in the zone in Bella Roma. One of the downfalls of walking or exploring Rome in high summer, intense heat. Lots of shade that we discover, but Circo Massimo gives you no reprise from the sun. But it's okay. You can cut through it. Don't follow navigation. Use your brains. Shortcut across. Save time. And now we're heading to the Colosseo. So what do you think it is?
Sex toy.
You think it's sex toy?
Yes, it is. Of course it's a sex toy. What for?
Walking down the other cross or looking to the cross?
Oh no, I give you a present. I give.
Piazza di Popolo, also known as the People's Square. The piazza lies inside the northern gate of the Aurelian walls, once Porta Flaminia of ancient Rome and the gateway to the city of Rome. and for centuries the home of public executions. Redesigned by Valadier inside the northern gate of the Aurelian Wall, with the incredible obelisk of Ramses II in the middle of the square. The entrance of the Tridente from Piazza di Popolo is defined by the twin churches of Santa Maria in Monte Santo and Santa Maria di Miracoli. The incredible Villa Borghese has spectacular views of the city, a beautiful lake to canoe around and get lost under the trees on a romantic day. It's also home to a zoological garden, equestrian, and lots of sports places. Enjoy a stroll and escape from the heat of Rome.
Piazza Villa Borghese, overlooking Piazza di Popolo, in the distance is San Pietro from the Vatican. You see a lot of Rome from up there. Great breeze and a great way to escape the heat of the day. Villa Borghese.
Not a bad little parrot to have. I can hear other ones up in the air. Hey, yo.
He's here.
It's absolutely incredible looking down over the beautiful and ancient city of Rome. All roads led to Rome. The city of eternal life, Bella Roma.
Per sentirmi bene. Bella Roma, che ne pensi?
Mi manca per sentirmi bene. Mi manca una ragazza, ma mi sento in catene. Son pazzo, mi taglio le vene. Son pazzo, affogo nelle pene. Son pazzo.
The beautiful and popular Piazza di Spagna and the Spanish Chefs, incredible for sunsets. We also produced for Roberto Cavalli, Donna Sotto la Stella. Here's a taste of what was the most famous fashion show on the planet with Luca Tomazzini and Jerry Halliwell.
Good looking, bad tasting, look at me. I'm the drama queen, if that's your thing, baby. I can even do reality. Fake honey, real plastic, stupid cupid, fantastic, queer thinking, straight
on the Spanish steps into Piazza di Spagna. Via condotti.
Incredible rooftop apartments, stunning greenery, and incredible views.
Sometimes I don't recognize my own face. My little white lies tell a story.
Questa strada sembra finta e dipinta da...
Of course, the beautiful Fontana di Trevi.
C'è un
Marcello, come here!
Infamous for Fellini's La Dolce Vita.
Ed un poco di...
Fontana di Trevi. Famosissima. Mi matto con gente.
Fortunately, totally overcrowded, so if you can find a moment to get that serenity in front of the fountain, it's spectacular.
The amazing Piazza Navona is one of those favorite places that you go. It's filled with tourist moments, painters, people selling their wares, but spectacular views of the fountains at night. The best about Piazza Navona is the side streets towards Bar della Pace and Bar della Figa, gelaterias and limoncello, or even get to wander into the deeper streets close to Maria della Pace. Surprisingly, it was only recently that I discovered that Piazza Navona was actually the Stadio Domiziano, the very first masonry stadium in ancient Rome, the home to the chariot.
And you have now this new underground experience, but never worry.
Italiani e italiane, in patria e nel mondo, ascoltate!
Welcome to the antique cafeteria in San Pietro. All the amazing Italian brands, fresh food, parmesan, cheese.
Campo di Fiori is one of my favorite places in Rome. It used to be a place where we used to hang out in the squares away from all the tourist crowds, just with the locals. Take wines from the wine bars and drink in the squares in plastic cups. During the day, there's traditional markets, and all around are artisans.
And the markets disappear in the evening, all said. Masses to embrace. Sunset sips, wine tasting, and dinner in Campo di Fiori.
And now into the night, you'll find incredible restaurants, amazing bars, and a lot of people gathering just to enjoy the night and enjoy La Dolce Vita.
Here we are, very close to Campo di Fiori, between Campo di Fiori and Piazza Navona. This is one of my favorite places in Rome. It's called Insalata Rica. Great salads on the street. I've been coming here since 91, I believe, and it was open in 83. Incredible. Come and enjoy. You'll enjoy it.
Insalata di pescatore here at Insalata Rica.
Tocca il cuore e l'anima, scatto senza fine, le tutti. Restiamo insieme in questi attimi.
So throughout Rome, there's a lot of repairs and renovations and protection going on. Seen through the bars, the Vittorio Emanuele and everything there, so quite interesting.
Piazza Venezia under construction, monument of Vittorio Emanuele, though known as the wedding cake. On our way, all over Rome today, touch base, the eternal city.
We're across Rome to the beloved wedding cake at Piazza Venezia. Tribute, Vittorio Emanuele.
The spectacular and breathtaking building that is the monument of Vittorio Emanuele II, the first king of a unified Italia. Also known as the wedding cake, this incredible monument can be seen from all over Rome.
So, I want to join this bird in the waterfall. That is not bad. Freschezza, bellezza, romano. Sisters, take the last steps.
Step, let's take it.
Guys, after 10 days, how is it? We're at the back of the line.
Church, went through a doorway, came down, and there's multiple chapels all around. There's a wedding happening with wedding photography happening on the stairs, and beyond that you can hear the music. Someone's playing the laundry of the church. Sono dopo. We've got a few old ruins, as one of the tourists just said. Of course it's the Roman Forum, which is below us. Spectacular beyond. You look up to parts of Rome. And just in front of us is the incredible tiny piazza designed by Michelangelo. So we're going to go and enjoy, explore, remember, in Rome, walk through the door. And lo and behold, the Greek god Athena is here, ever present, even in Rome. Here I am, in the middle of my old stomping grounds, home near Via Cavour. Nella Roma.
Roma, an amazing place. It's got pancetta, it's got pochetta, it's got amazing sauces and everything we're about to jump in, but looks delicious. Come check it out, Villa Roma.
I got Villano. It's pochetta da riccia, sugo di pomodoro, tomato sauce paste, like a bolognese type of paste, parmigiano, and pepe nero. Oh boy, this is gonna be nice.
The sugo di pomodoro really makes a difference on this one. It's a really good sauce. You can taste it.
And now for your nice ladies and gentlemen out there who don't understand the Italian language, I'd like to do two choruses in
So this is Capriccio di Cala. Artisanal, I get that word stuck, but artisanal gelateria. Come and check it out, incredible. I'll send you the link.
Un gelato al limone, vero limone.
Merengue, chocolate e salsa caramel.
Mentre un altro estate se ne va.
So, artisanal gelato. This place is...
Ecco quello che io ti darò.
Buonissimo, dolcissimo, incredibile, it's amazing. Great taste. The sorbet that Caro got is just so light and fizzy and palate cleans will wake you up. I got something heavier, but the flavors are very good. And this is a trick. Apparently, the trick to the best gelato is actually not when they put it on display with all the colors and fruits. It looks impressive, but doesn't taste as good. It's a wine with the closed tops, and it's that's a trick. The best Italian gelato. So we tried here. This is one we're going to do the challenge today. This is meant to be the best, and we're going to see one in Trastevere and see if it's any good as well. Yeah.
Caro got Sorrento di limone.
Very good.
We're back at the end of the day. Kilometers made, kilometers walked. Not needed so much the trees, but we're once again by the Tevere. Some olive oil for the bread to drop in and to do it like that. But we're just, like Carol did, we're just gonna taste.
Mm-hmm.
Mozzarella. So it's a flour of zucchini fried with mozzarella di bufala and alici, which is anchovies. We're just tasting.
In Italy, one of the words or the things that you do when something is good, you go buono, which means it's good.
What I'm liking.
So walking through the artistic retro area of Trastevere, which is really known for its incredible food. It's one of the main food districts in Villa Roma. Come and check it out. Very green, nice and shaded in the days. So Trastevere, you're in the zone.
Ma è lì di altri quando giochi te, sei l'ultimo qua, è diventato.
Mi hanno preso cappotto, se è deficiente! Ma deficiente, ma sono venuto a te!
S'affacciano dai tetti e ristan là sui vicoli a guardare. Trastevere, cuore semplice de Roma, se qualcuno si innamora è come se bruciasse il cielo. Se tu mi baci, se tu non mi baci, stasera amore ti bacerò. Se tu mi ami, se tu non mi ami, con tutto il cuore io t'amerò. Con questa luna trasteverina che fa impazzire, che fa sognare. Roma, Roma, splendida come il sole. Roma, Roma, voglio restare con te. La legge dell'amore, solo questa qua, fai quel che dice il cuore, bacia se tu vuoi baciare. Trastevere, tutto un cielo di finestre, mille stelle di una notte, insieme a me sorridono per te. Trastevere, l'acqua delle tue fontane canta per accarezzare, te ubriaca chi vuol sognare. Se tu mi baci, se tu non mi baci, stasera amore ti bacerò. Se tu mi ami, se tu non mi ami, con tutto il cuore io t'amerò. Con questa luna trasteverina che fa impazzire, che fa sognare. Roma, Roma, splendida come il sole. Roma, Roma, voglio restare con te. Legge dell'amore, solo questa qua, fai quel che dice il cuore, bacia se tu vuoi, bacia.
La notte più bella, si vive meglio, per chi fino alle 5 non conosce Spadini, la città riprende fiato e sembra che dorme. Il buio la trasforma, e tutto è più tranquillo, tutto è vicino, e non esiste traffico, non c'è casino, almeno quello brutto, quello che stressa, la gente della notte è sempre la stessa, ci si conosce tutti, come in un paese, sempre le stesse facce, mese dopo mese, il giorno cambia leggi, cambia governi, e passano l'estate, passano gli inverni, la gente della notte sopravvive sempre.
In Moscow, fish lab, and you've got things like salmon tacos, you've got
just have a look what else there is. I saw up on the board you have, and it was hamburger. I mean, just look at the cook on those tomatoes. I think it's going to be very cool. We come back later when we're hungry. And they even have like a kebab with things.
So, don't be dissuaded because in Tosca, but it's a place called Street Food Blues. It looks sensational. The concept is new. Let's see the quality of it. New region
of Cosimato, I think it was called. Octopus burger. It's good. It's really good. For an octopus, tender, tasty. The tomatoes are cooked perfectly. Wow, very good.
Di notte le parole scorrono più lente, però è molto più facile parlare con la gente.
The glorious Pantheon, in Greek meaning a temple of the gods, was a Roman temple until 609 AD when it became a Catholic church. The spectacular dome, even 2,000 years later, is still the world's largest unreinforced concrete dome. The spectacular oculus allows sunlight into the temple, illuminating the various statues with natural sunlight. Sparirà mamma, farai ogni tristezza una poesia, su un foglio bianco sparirà, farai nelle tue lacrime una melodia. The mausoleum of Hadrian the Emperor is also known as the Castel San Angelo. Was initially commissioned by the Roman Emperor Hadrian as his mausoleum for he and his family. Later the popes used the building as a fortress and a castle. It is now a museum. Legend holds that the Archangel Michael appeared atop the mausoleum, sheathing his sword as a sign of the end of the plague in 590, thus lending the castle its present name.
Rome is actually the home of two capitals in one city, the Italian capital and the home of the Pope in the Vatican. The 2025 Jubilee marks an exceptional year in Rome. During the year-long event, those of Catholic faith are encouraged to make the pilgrimage to the Basilica San Pietro. The Basilica San Pietro is a church of Italian High Renaissance, constructed in the 15th century. The original church was constructed in the 4th century by Roman Emperor Constantine the Great. Its major religious significance is the tomb of Saint Peter. The Vaticano, with its smallest microstate, has 764 citizens. It even has its own postal system. It also houses the incredible St. Peter's Basilica, the Sistine Chapel, Vatican Apocalyptic Library, and the Vatican Museums. They feature some of the world's most famous paintings, sculptures, and artworks. Discover Bella Roma, the city of eternal life, in the zone.